Hi, welcome to Savvy's Fashion Studio. I'm Savita. In my previous class, you have seen how to use this flower stitch foot and create circular patterns. In this class, I'll show how to use this ruffler foot and make gathered or pleated ruffles. There's also option to change the depth or distance between the pleats. Let me show it in detail. First, let me show how to install it. These presser feet can be bought on our website savvysfashionstudio.com. These are compatible with most low shank home sewing machines. So let's start. Now let's see how to install this ruffler foot. Remove the regular presser foot along with the shank. So loosen the shank screw. Now you see this U shape. This fork of this arm should rest on this needle clamp, and as the needle moves up and down, this will move too, and along with that, ruffling blade will move forward and backward, which creates the ruffles. So this needs to sit in the needle clamp. This is how you install it. Let this go here, and this part here will go here, and then you need to tighten the screw. By turning the hand wheel, adjust the needle position so that it does not touch the foot as you install it. Now tighten the screw. Tighten it completely. Now you see the blade moves along with this, and that's how the ruffles are formed. Now let's see the different options here. The slot one that you see here is for gathers. So lift the adjusting lever and put in the first slot. Now place the fabric to be ruffled or gathered between the ruffling blade and the separator blade. That is, the fabric goes here and under this guide. Let the fabric end be little beyond needle. Now lower the presser foot. You see this adjusting screw here. When you set this to a smaller number, lesser gathers or small tucks are formed. And when you set this to a bigger number, more gathers or deeper tucks are formed. To set this, you just need to loosen the screw and move this pointer to the number that you want. And then tighten. Also, the fullness of gathers and ruffles depends on the stitch length that you're using. Now I have set the stitch length at 2. Just let's see how this comes. This is how it's come. By increasing or decreasing the stitch length, you can increase or decrease the fullness of the gathers. Now the same gathers, let me show with different setting. That is, I'll change the stitch length to 4. Place the fabric in the same way. Now here I had used the stitch length 4. So without changing any setting here, just by changing the stitch length also, you can control the fullness. This was done with stitch length 2 and this with 4. Now let me show the ruffles. Lift the adjusting lever and use the slot 6. That is, for every 6th stitch, there will be a pleat. And the depth of the pleat can be controlled here by choosing a bigger number or a smaller number. Place the fabric in the same way. Lower the presser foot. Now I'll adjust this to a bigger number, tighten the screw, start sewing. I'm keeping the stitch length at 2. Now let me change the setting to a smaller number. Every 6th stitch there is a pleat, and again here you see the pleat depth is less because we chose a smaller number. Now let's also see number 12. That is, for every 12th stitch there will be a pleat. Now we are using the slot 12. So this is how it looks. Now you have seen how to use these slots. Now I'll also show how to make the ruffles and also simultaneously attach it to a fabric. Assume this is the base fabric to which the ruffle is to be attached. Now how to insert this is above this first guide here and then under, and put the fabric under this separating blade. Now take the fabric to be ruffled and insert it the same way as you have seen earlier. That is, under this ruffling blade. and under the guide here and above. Adjust the lever as per your need. I'll keep it at 6. Adjust the depth of the ruffle or pleat and the stitch length. Start sewing. Now if you see, this fabric is not getting ruffled. So this is how it is. Now you see how easy it is to make the ruffles and simultaneously attach it to the garment. So you can add this to skirts, pillow covers, curtains, cushions and to your dresses. I had taken this ruffle fabric double the length of the base fabric. It's almost exact. When making ruffles and sewing it to the flat fabric simultaneously, you need to place the fabrics right sides facing each other. The fullness or volume of ruffles also depends on the kind of fabric you use. If it's a very thin fabric, it's good to use the gathers, that is slot 1. And if it's stiff fabric, it's good to use pleated ruffles. So before doing on the actual garment, always try on a swatch of fabric to see if you like the result and then make the changes to the settings or the stitch length. As this presser foot has moving parts, occasionally oiling it will keep it in good condition. You just need to oil very little, just a drop in the moving parts. Let me just put one drop of oil here. You see that it moves here. And another drop here, the wheel here moves. And a drop of oil here. Now that you've learned how to use these two presser feet, let's use it in a project. So in the next class, let's create a cushion cover where I've used the flower stitch foot and the ruffler foot. Thanks for watching this class. If you like this class, please like, share and subscribe. See you soon in the next class. Until then, happy sewing.